Alrighty, let's see here. Okay, I think we're good. Tweet has been sent off. Everything is solid. So, now, howdy folks, and welcome back to the Flying TBRC. And how the hell are you? But it is time for a midday matinee, which means we are going to be diving back into Evil West. Probably going to beat it today. Because we got two levels left, really, that's it. And let's face it, the last level is not much of a level. It's just two really hard fights. And this time we're tackling them solo, so yeah. But let's go ahead and whoops, hang on. Shit, I forgot to do a thing. By the way, thank you for the Prime sub there, Dustafool. I really appreciate it, dude. I forgot to change the tags for the stream. I wish there was a way that you could just be like, these tags are what I use all the time. Would speed this process up a little bit. You hear that, Twitch? Make it happen. Okay, there we go. Stream tags are now caught up and finished. So let's go ahead and we're gonna dive right into it, considering I pulled the stupid. And make sure we have noise. And voila! Oops, I forgot I could do that if I wanted to. I need to get another one of them good wireless pads. Also, I need to grab a beer.
We'll grab one of the ice cold ones.
So, folks, just remember, pop top again. Think I got time for one more round. Set it up, my friends. Rifle, crossbow. All right, let's freaking do this. Trying to keep my eyes open for gold. Oh, so it just takes three times and then they just go away. That would have been nice to freaking know the first time through this.
Well, it was straight ahead.
Ooh, money.
I'm taking it. Money.
Money. Good, Jesse Rentier. Alright. More money. Yeah, if I remember correctly, this is not an option. Ow! You, buddy. So, no monies. Never hurts to check. Oh crap.
Now what? A fucking train?
Screw you, jerk.
Let me enlighten you folks.
Come on. Uno más. That's what I have to say to you.
Fire!
Come on, jerk. Come on. Gotcha. Hey, we got the death ray. Apparently I missed a box somewhere.
Road clear.
Ho ho. Big money. So we need 10,000, 18,000. So we need 18,000 gold to potentially get the last two big upgrades. As for perk points, do the cannonball explosion. Oh! Grover Cleveland. In 1870, Grover Cleveland was elected sheriff of Erie County. This led to his election as the mayor of Buffalo, New York. In 1882, he ran for governor and won. He fought the corrupt Tammany Hall machine of New York City, and that battle brought him national recognition. He won the Democratic nomination in 1884 and eventually became the 22nd and 24th president of the United States. And apparently we have a new monster. Oh, right. William Rentier, the Sanguisuge. When William is seemingly saved by the Regent compound, he gradually succumbs to vampirism. Eventually, he becomes a powerful highborn who believes that this new eternal life is a blessing, ensuring the very best version of himself. All sorts of good stuff here. Money.
I'll take that.
Oh crap. Where is it? Crap. Kemma, Kemma. I think this is the first time I've seen that execution. Using the crippling rod to like blow the back of their head out, apparently. I mean, I guess you can do that with an EMP. Oh, would you look at that? There's a rope. I do know we're coming up on a part here soon that's gonna be rough.
More money.
Hell yes. Keep stacking that money on me. I doubt I'm gonna get 10,800, so we might have to give up a different upgrade. But then again, I don't know if I really wanna get the death ray one. Like, it's cool. But if I remember correctly, it's not like insanely stupid useful. Hi there, big fellers. Who would have ever thought a trick like that would work? Screw you guys. And the horses you rode in on. Oopsie-daisy.
I'm coming.
Oh, right. Go find us some bloody pockets.
I'm taking it.
saves. That put us at 9,000. Not bad. Not great, but not bad. Pippus.
Fucking maniacs.
Peter DeBono experiments with ancient blood. The formula is designed to further the evolution of his species by extending the Sanguisuchus' potential to assume their true form and enhancing their natural abilities. Has Felicity been a willing participant in his experiments? Or maybe it was a price she paid for her change. Doesn't matter which it was, she's still a little psycho.
Damn it, more seals.
So, broke that one. Oh, so a third one pops up after you shoot the second. Oh! Fudge! I forgot about all of you! You stupid spider shooters.
Now, where's the third one?
This way. But we also have to look for gold and papers.
More money.
Oh, look, papers. Peter DeBono and his daughter Felicity, 1801. Ooh, I think I see money on the ground. I do see money on the ground. And I see money on the table. And I shoot the thing. So we've got 11,000. Hmm. I mean, it's not going to make it any worse, that's for sure. Yeah, we'll grab it, and then if we happen to get enough money, we'll do the improved rifle. But I definitely need these. And the crossbow fully leveled up is just phenomenal. Electric shotgun is where it's at. Lightning tornado, also, it's just where it's at. Shit, what do I want the last one to be? I mean, yeah, this one's a good perk. Every fifth gauntlet executioner. So yeah, I don't think we need to do a full reset.
Can stop me? Think again.
As I glow with electric brilliance.
DeBono? The fuck?
This is great, Cassie.
I know you're sharpening your teeth for the president, but you want to turn him. But since I shut down your leech farm and stopped the plague, there's just not enough of you freaks to simply walk into the White House.
What are you? Die! No!
How does she plan to do it?
No! Stop! Just a failed opera! There's a premier! President won't be there! Exposed! With almost no security! It changes nothing. Washington is too far from here. You'll never make it in time.
Watch me.
So we have a buddy with a head again.
Lock and load.
and look for the president.
Send Felicity our regards.
Let's tear his fangs, sons of bitches, and you asshole.
Seriously? What happened to Potty Mouth?
Don't fuck with Dr. Blackwell. Oh, fuck me. Okay, so we got one down. Thank you. Whew. Holy crap. Money. More money. Okay, this is going a lot faster than I thought it was going to go. I thought... But that's also considering I beat Felicity quickly. Because chances are that ain't going to happen. So 2,000... We want sticky bombs. We definitely want the improved cooldown. The cocoon is nice. And honestly, yeah, we're fine. I think I have, what, one more level? So I'll get another 2,000, but it's not going to be enough to get any of the, to get the last perk that I actually want. All right, big fellers. Real big fellas.
Yeah.
die, stupid. Okay. So, that was all of that. Got 4,000 bucks to do something with. Now, as far as this crap is concerned, I mean, sure, the energy pickup, whatever. Spit flames 30% further. Forming a zapper pool or dash supercharges the gauntlet and greatly increases that. Midair shot, which is not going to be useful. This is probably going to be the most useful at the moment. Two additional bolts. Alright, let's go give this a shot, shall we?
I'm so glad you're here to witness this great change. With the president joining our bloodline, sharing his secrets just like your father did, we cannot be stopped!
We'll see about that.
I tried to make you understand. In order to build something, you need to demolish its past.
Your stupid ambition took everything from me. You turned my father against me and everything he stood for. That was a fate worse than death. I'm here to make sure you won't do the same to anyone else.
Hi, Felicity. Oh, God. Eat grenade! Now.
I paid the fuck a while ago! Leadership is not for you!
God! You, Felicity!
You can't reach me!
No. Ow.
It's not pride when you rid of the weak. It's mercy.
Hell.
You can't reach me.
Oh shit. Oh, wow.
There's no pride when you kill the weak. It's mercy. You never deserve to be one of us.
Ah, shit.
You can't reach me. You'll never match your father.
Ow.
You're nothing but a boring monster slayer.
Okay, phase one down. Okay, so death ray, not super great. Oh, geez. Dodge again. Dodge again. Nope, wrong type of dodge. Ow.
Calico. Leadership is not for you.
Okay, phase two down. Whew. All right, come on, Felicity. Gotta watch. For that type of crap more. Oof. Ow. Oh shit. Whoops.
You lost your chance, Jesse Ripley.
Oh god. Whew! Ha! Ah. Grenade to the face! For the win!
Is contained, sir. The Institute's resources were finally put to good use. It was just a matter of proper management. We couldn't allow for it to be led like a small town family business, or even worse, to be run by a woman.
Sir, this man continuously abused his position of power for personal gain. His poor decisions jeopardized the whole country, and for that alone, he should be put behind bars.
James. Dr. Blackwell here has shared some rather interesting information on your conduct of late. If even half of those allegations are true, I'm afraid you're done for. Mr. Rentier, your father was a great friend. Seeing your performance today, I have no doubt that his legacy is secure. I wonder, it appears we're down a Secretary of War. Ever see yourself in the capital, son?
Oh. I ain't much behind a desk.
Fair enough. Then I'll see to it that full control of the Rentier Institute is returned to you. I'm afraid only you have the necessary skills to deal with a conflict like the one we appear to be facing.
We do, sir. We do. But to win this, we need to be bigger than ever.
And smarter.
With better protocols.
And stronger lines of communication.
Well, it sounds like you two have it all under control. You've got my full support in any way I can provide, son. Carte blanche, as they say. Sky's the limit.
So I do like the fact that they leave it kind of open to a potential sequel at some point. Like, I think that would be pretty awesome. Okay, so, final thoughts on the solo playthrough of Evil West. So story-wise, again, I like the story of this. It's really straightforward. It's not overly complicated, which is wonderful in my opinion. Like, as much as I love world building and making games insanely big, having a simple, straightforward game that's just enjoyable is fun. And to do that, you have to have a simple storyline. Now, could they have fleshed out certain parts of the story better? Yes. But, you know, maybe we'll get some more details on the Sanguisuge and the Orchid de la Vida and all that stuff. Like, why does the Orchid work the way it does? So, you know, and certain things like that. Personally, I'm also kind of invested in Chester as a character. Because Chester was just funny. Like, I liked the idea that Felicity and DeBono were, like, these hoity-toity royalty noble types who were trying to do this thing. And Chester's just an everyday one. It's just essentially trying to survive. And he's like, yeah, no, this is bad for business. He's that unlikely ally character that I always find intriguing. And also, he's very funny, in my opinion, compared to most of the other characters. Let's see here. What else? Well, I mean, that's really it as far as the story goes. It's... So then... game progression, again... very nice. Just, it's no real change because the solo playthrough is really the same. I will say that there is definitely a huge degree of difficulty change between co-op and solo. There were certain encounters in this game that took me and my buddy Sling several attempts to actually get all the way down that I managed to do first try. Now they do, of course, say up front that in co-op, they bump up the health and make enemies more difficult and stuff. But considering I started this game on hard mode, and then switched to normal mode, and then did... Wait, no, did I start on hard mode? No, I don't think I did start on hard mode in this one. Like, I did normal mode the entire way through, and even then I still got my ass whipped sufficiently throughout the game. On normal mode and co-op, it was worse. So I would imagine that normal mode on co-op is pretty comparable to hard mode on normal mode. You just have the benefit of an ally who can revive you, so if you guys have good teamwork, then it's not as much of a challenge. Like, me and Sling died several times against Felicity and the big fight before her with the three ancient vampires, the three highborn vampires. Difficulty wise though, I mean, normal mode is good. Obviously this game is meant to be replayed through, so who knows, we might come back to it later and get some more stuff, or honestly we're probably going to go back and reinvestigate some chapters once I get done giving final thoughts and the credits are done. But just because I didn't expect to beat it that quick, to be perfectly honest. I thought it was going to take longer. So there's all that. Now, actual gameplay. Obviously, way less buggy on solo than it is on co-op. This leads me to believe that a large portion of the bugs in co-op are not actually from the game, but due to latency and connectivity issues from having a wireless link to whoever you're co-oping with. Because I feel like a lot of the issues I had personally in the co-op playthrough could be summed up as latency issues, like the game not switching between rifle and crossbow when it's supposed to. On the flip side though, I did have issues where the crossbow would not fire. Like, I couldn't use the crossbow even though I had selected the crossbow. And stuff like that, which I think that is strictly on the game, not on latency issues per se. Obviously, all the levels and puzzles and stuff run way smoother. We saw in the lightning in the bottle level that I think I had one game crash on solo on that level. But that was, I mean, it was what it was, I guess. So yeah, overall, like, this game's a solid 7.5. Does it have room to improve upon stuff? Yes. Does it need to in order to be fully enjoyable? No. Like, honestly, I'm even leaning more towards 8, but I think I'm being too nice to games. Had somebody tell me that not too long ago. They're like, man, you need to be more critical. And so I'm trying to be. So actually, I'll update the rating a little bit. So 7.5 to 8 for this game out of 10. With the biggest redeeming factor being the fact that this game is just fucking fun. Like, it is just a lot of fun, plain and simple. So yeah, I mean, that's really it. Considering I still have like an hour and 40 minutes that I would normally try to stream, I think we're going to go back and revisit some levels and try to find some hidden stuff and see if we can get like the last couple upgrades as well as all the other money pickups that we did not get the first time around. But as a sign of respect for the developers and whatnot, we are not ending these credits until they restart again. This is just because the fact that, you know what, I think that I believe most streamers should do this just because of the fact that these guys put a lot of time and effort into these games. And they deserve credit for it. And so I guess my small way of saying, of giving them that credit, is to make sure that they, their name gets seen on my stream. And is it just me, or is there a lot of Russian... Is it Russian or East European names that I keep seeing? Because I definitely keep seeing some stuff. Oh, that is another thing I will say is a small pull away on stuff. Is like, I wish Bloom would have had a little bit more of a part. I feel like him diving into some more of the ancient history stuff behind all this could have been more interesting. But again, maybe this is something they'll dive to in a potential sequel, if they do. Just like, oh, some of the enemy types are from a Native American tribe. And as such, like, it makes me wonder if there are Native American tribes who would, like, team up with the Rentier Institute, if possible. Like, that could be interesting. Also, considering the fact, like, I know this was obviously a vampires with some werewolf stuff being thrown in. But if they do continue this series, there's one thing I think would be really interesting, is if they started throwing in other stuff. So, like, maybe give us, like, they had very Frankenstein-esque monsters, but maybe do an actual, like, Frankenstein monster. Or, I mean, I also believe it might be very possible, like the Sanguisuge, they're vampires, but some of them turned into werewolves. So I wonder how that works, too. So, yeah, I definitely hope they do a sequel so that they can dive into some of that stuff. And maybe we'll meet some other supernatural beasts in the Old West. Although, considering this takes place in, like, the late 1870s, right? It's kind of towards the tail end of the Old West. So, who knows? Like, it takes kind of the same era as like Red Dead Redemption, where yes, you have like the quote unquote Old West, but America had settled both the East and West by this point. There was just a lot of quote unquote unclaimed between the East and West. If I'm right, like, don't take me to the bank on those timelines. Because, like, this one, you can also tell, mostly takes place, like, there's DC, and then Dickinson's really isn't too far away from DC. What else was there? Then, of course, like, you're down in the swamp, but that's still, like, the eastern end of the country. Only the first level, or the first and third level, take place based off a geography, like the landscape. It would be further west, because it was a very Arizona New Mexico type area. While the swamp, on the other hand, you don't run into any swamps until, like, if you're starting on the west coast and going east. I mean, I might be wrong about this, but I'm pretty sure, like, the southern ends of Alabama and whatnot is where you start getting kind of swampy territory. But I also might be totally wrong about that. Might just be talking out my ass. But I like to think I might know a little bit about what I'm talking about. IT and support. Crap, I don't know if legal team. Okay, I don't think we've seen this yet. Testing company. I feel like we might have, though, because we already saw a special thanks. And I was rambling on for a good minute. And I do remember that it just starts it over partway through. Or not partway through, but it just keeps repeating the stuff over and over. So we're going to go ahead and do this. So select slave slot. Well, crud. Like, I have to start it over. Shit, I should have made a separate save file. I was hoping to be able to go back and just chapter select, but I don't think I can. I have to start it a new game plus. Well, shit. Crap, what am I gonna do? So we still have some time, and I can just... Ooh, but splitting the stream is stupid. I hate having... Let's think here for a second. Yeah, I think we're going to do that. So I'll deal with the dumbness of splitting the streams and whatnot.